Yeah, the cricketers view this carefully. And a very good morning from here in Beijing. On the map, you'll see we're on the return long sector back to Amsterdam. Let's get this flight underway, because we have a lot of flying to do. Right. And make sure our parking brakes are set. Yep. Battery switch on. APU master off, APU generator off. APU start. On, on. Up, cut off, 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 and the ice controls auto. Auto, auto. Let's get those fuel pumps on. Fuel pumps are on. Engine efficiency and the ice controls, as I said, are auto. Window heating is required. That's our strobes on. I really want to see if we can get those overhead lights on. I can't see. Overhead panel, here we go. Zone, perfect. So that's a fuel quantity on. The seatbelt signs on. Fuel quantity checked. Engine throttle limiter braking. Checked takeoff. Good, that's bright. RTO, rejected takeoff. Okay, let's program up the FMC. Right. Yep. So let's go position init page. We are in excuse me, we are in ZBAA. There we go. Bang. Bang. Depart. ZBAA 36, brilliant. And we're arriving. Yep, brilliant. Let's go init ref. Performance page. We're cruising to date altitude of 36,000 feet. There we go. Reserves 10. There we go. Thrust limits and takeoff. Let's see. Takeoff flaps 5 degrees on that. That's all very good. Execute all of that. Yeah, legs, awesome. Okay, I think that's all nicely set up. I gotta get the packs, make sure they're all on. Packs are on, yep. Beacon logo light is on, beacon light is on, nav lights are on. Okay, we are pretty much good to your damper, everything should be on. We're pretty much good to push back and start. Let's come down to our map. We're departing out runway 36, so let's get that brake off and start pushing back. Okay, engine start selectors, where are you? Fuel 36,000 feet, and nav. Fuel. Gauge flight directors, there we go. If your generator's off, that's a logo ring, that's all good. Anti-ice. Switch up to auto. There we go. And panel master brightness. So, runway turn-offs. Taxi. There we are. Brilliant. Flaps. We are prepared for our departure. We need anything else? Strobes. Got strobes on. Right, taxi strobe lights. We'll put those on now. May as well. Oh, I don't need them to bet later. Okay, let's taxi on round. There's our parking brake. There. Brilliant. Figured out how to turn this plane there. Let's waggle the controls till it turns. Right. We're in position, ready for takeoff. We'll put the main lights on. Wing, everything is all good. Okay, that's the part out then. Positive rates. Autopilot, V nerve engage. Let's get the lights off. Off, 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 off. Oops. Off, off. Lego off. Taxi off. Strobes can stay on. Passenger signs can be turned off. We'll go to the wing view and we'll see you folks on the other side. can see for our approach into Schiphol, the weather is not looking particularly inviting. We left early morning Beijing. It is now early morning Amsterdam. We've pretty much spent the entire flight in darkness. So we'll be approaching on runway 18. Right, 110.10. That's about what we want to be. As we come down, circle round to land in Amsterdam. Very strong 103 knot headwind at the moment, certainly not helping matters. So we'll need to descend down 2,000 feet, and of course 36,000 feet. We'll set the LTOF approach. Hey, what happened there? That dropped to 75, there we go. That's about 150, 30, 150. The flaps. Exhibiting fuel load. We have 60. Yeah, we have plenty of fuel in the tanks. I say we will begin our descent momentarily. and see what kind of weather we can expect in Shippo. Yeah, pulls at distance from destination. Okay. Forecast. It's working. Okay, let's begin a slow descent down to 2,000 feet then. Ladies and gentlemen, we're beginning a descent down into Amsterdam. And nighttime landing for us. You can see the cloud. Some Amsterdam weather. Search Schiphol Airport. 14 degrees, 12 degrees, 14 winds. But nothing too drastic. Inbound from Beijing, Chinese capital. Returning home to a grey and wet Schiphol. There's a surprise. See if we can land this plane nicely again. We did in Beijing. See if we can repeat that success in Amsterdam. You know what airports that we're flying over. See where we are on the map. Ah, Grenoken. So we've got ATIP twice, we don't need ATIP twice. Surely we can delete one of those out now. Oh, hello, someone here. Didn't want to do that, did I? Where are you coming? Ah, no, what's it done now? Oh, you stupid ass piece of crap. Knew I shouldn't have fiddled about with that. There we go. Brilliant. Protect our tip. Don't let me go to the previous page. You know what? Screw you. Not sure where we're going now, to be honest. Hopefully back onto the track. There we go. Yeah, I think the trick with this plane is to leave the FMC alone. Right, let's put the... let's touch some things we are brave enough to touch. Should actually be the radio. Never mind. It says Barry, you just see a turret. You just do your own thing here. Yeah? Right, where's the rejected takeoff switch on this plane? It's here. So we're going to put the autobrake on. We'll say that's 250 knots as we near. Approach, yeah, sure. There we go. And we're sending it a reasonable a rate. Say we'll slow the speed right down as we get. Yeah, there's nothing wrong slowing it down now, actually, to be honest. Yes, please do zoom out. It's precisely what I want you to do. It's been an absolutely completely annoying piece of crap. There we go. Let's ease that speed back a little bit. So we descend through 16,000 feet. Put the seatbelt signs on as we're starting to bounce around. There we go. Lovely. So we are in preparation for landing in Schiphol, Amsterdam. Which, as you can see, looks to be just on the edge of that weather front. It's got a really abrupt line, hasn't it? That's quite interesting. Shame it's not daylight, that probably looked quite impressive. But yeah, it's a time of the year where there's going to be more and more night flying, especially in the Northern Hemisphere. As we are fast approaching shortest day. Slow to 250 knots, shall we? T-60, 40, 43 is 12. Yeah, we're good on our altitude, I think. Pretty happy with that. Dive out another notch. Might even be able to ease it up a little bit, because we've got to do almost like that circle round to land thing, haven't we? No sign of the ground. Of course there wouldn't be, because it's, well, thick cloud. And we're landing on the runway in Schiphol that is 6 billion miles away from anywhere else. Joy! So SPL, so we literally overfly Schiphol and then come down and round to land. So yeah, I think we can actually ease up that rate of descent a little bit. Ease up a little bit more actually, there we go. Otherwise we'll get down too low too quickly. As we drop down through 11,000 feet, let's get the lights on, ready for landing. See that we're we're in the cloud. Down around, circle it, arrive into runway 18, see if we can definitely reduce that rate of descent. Gosh, fancy weather being like this in Amsterdam. There's a surprise. I'm so surprised. Oh no, wait, I'm not. Ladies and gentlemen, we shall soon be arriving into Schiphol, Amsterdam. Where's the localizer switch on this plane? There's the approach button. And there's a localizer. What's up there? Really? Oh yeah, makes sense above the approach button. Sure, why not? So yeah, we're good on the altitude at the moment. Lovely weather. Come and admit it, it wouldn't be an approach into Amsterdam if the weather was like this. It wasn't like this, rather. Let's go to QNH as well. Wrong way. Reduce our rate of descent, otherwise we're going to be stupidly low. Okay, we have 20 mile range. To descend back down. You can see it's raining. Beautiful weather. Welcome home for my KLM pilot. He's missed this weather, apparently. I need a name for him. What should I call him? I just love that weather front there, look at that, that's just like epic. So, does that mean there's no rain or no cloud, or will something come bursting out of the air? Okay, that'd be interesting to see, actually. Miles out, 3,000 feet. God, we can really crop back on that, otherwise we're just gonna be way too low. Out the rain, according to the radar, although there's some more there on approach. We're almost out of the yellow stuff anyway. We're descending, what, 2,000, yeah? There we go. I like following the Dreamliner. There's supposed to be some big updates to it, I've heard rumours of, to improve it. So I look forward to that happening. Oh, we're still in the cloud. Is this going to be down to minimums again? Hopefully we'll drop out of it. We did in Beijing. You're almost literally over. Skip all now. Start making a turn to the right. Yeah, I'm so playing even more. There, we drop down below 4,000 feet. Let's get SkyDolly recording. Jesus, this cloud base is low. Good old Schiphol. I mean, why would you have a clear, beautiful, starry night here This wouldn't be right, would it? Jesus, reduce the speed further. 2500. Yeah, we're above the below the glide doodah now. Just fabulous. Still in the murky crap, which is not so fabulous. We got water brakes armed. We got all the lights on that we need on. We are down at 2,000 feet. Ready to catch the glide slope. I've caught a glimpse of the ground, there we go, nice. When we're in sight. Get us up alive. They filling up wind. Maybe that's going to die down. So we drop down. Not showing any signs of wanting to drop down, to be honest. Make for an interesting landing. Okay, welcome to Schiphol, everybody. That wasn't too bad a landing, was it? Find our way to the gates now, having landed 6 million miles away from them. It floated a bit, but I think we handled the float quite well in the end. Sorry, that's just a sky dolly. I was playing about with that. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Schiphol Airport. It is good to be back, is it not? So we'll taxi, find ourselves a gate, and then we will, of course, have a look at the replay. Of course, finding the gate being the optimum challenge right at this precise moment. Can't wait to review the landing, actually, because I happen to think it's quite a good one. Getting better with these planes. What the? Oh yeah, I forgot about that. Just got to try and get up the other side now. It's going to be a real challenge. Come on, we can do this. Yeah. Yeah, if they could fix that, that'd be nice. Little quirks of the simulator. So we want to take second left. Cross a runway at 18 centre. So yeah, it's nice to be back in Amsterdam for my KLM pilot. He's home. Where will he be off to next? I don't know. I'm actually kind of hoping I get South Africa or somewhere in Africa. I suspect it's going to send me somewhere in America, like Atlanta or somewhere I've been 500 times, but I'm really hoping that I will get Atlanta. What am I saying? That I will get Africa. But we should see, where are we going now? Because the amount of taxing here is ridiculous. Oops. Turn, don't want to end up in there. There we go. So yeah, if you're having problems turning the Dreamliner, just, and you've got one of these like twist flight sticks, just keep twisting it back and forth from centre to whichever way you want to turn rapidly, and that seems to help turn it, rather than if you just hold it full twist. If you get what I'm saying. A bit difficult to explain, I know, but that's what I found, pretty much. Right, I can take second left here. I have actually, the runway we just landed on, I have actually landed on as a passenger, and the taxiing to wherever we went to, I swear, took longer than the flight. It's absolutely freaking ridiculous. Made even more awkward by the fact that we are flying a freaking... I'll tell you what, we can pull into these gates up here on the right, I think. And that'll be job done. I think gates G and H. It's a massive airport. Schiphol, it really is. You've got to love it though. It's a great airport. Flown in and out of it many times on the simulator, and indeed quite a fair few times in real life. Hello! I'll tell you what, we'll just park it here then, shall we? That was interesting. There we go, we're parking here. Brilliant. There we go. I guess we hit a building or something. I don't know, but anyway, here we'll do. Just have to just rip the wing off, but never mind. Anyway. Flights. Okay, so if we just have a... What's my landing rate? It says it was 213. Really? Felt a lot softer than that, to be honest. Right, let's review that landing then, shall we? Bum 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 bum. This is quite a windy final approach, wasn't it? Feeling,
300. 200.
Floated it, and then there we go. A little bit off the center line, but on the whole, a damn good landing, I think. So that brings us to the end of this flight. Realize you have a choice of flight, so very much choose this one. Wish you a pleasant on a browsing journey. Hope to welcome you back on board again in the very near future. So from here in Amsterdam, Schiphol, will leave you with a wing view of our arrival into this Dutch city. It's early morning arrival, inbound from Beijing. There we go, we'll finish there. Till next time, farewell for now.